over to other stories. You'll find them on the metro, in college classrooms, and maybe on your living room couch too. Online gamers are everywhere and their tribe is growing. But is the exponential increase in gaming enthusiasts something to worry about? The World Health Organization surely thinks so. And here's more on this story.
It's official. Too much gaming could be classified as a disorder. 194 members of the World Health Organization have recognized gaming disorder as an illness at the World Health Assembly. The global body has defined the disorder as, quote, a pattern of behavior characterized by impaired control over gaming, increasing priority given to gaming over other activities to the extent that gaming takes precedence over other interests and daily activities, and continuation or escalation of gaming despite the occurrence of negative consequences. The classification doesn't mean that anyone and everyone spending time gaming is suffering from the disorder. The WHO has specified what kind of behavior determines if the activity falls under the ambit of a disorder. It says, quote, the behavior pattern should be of sufficient severity to result in significant impairment in personal, family, social, educational, occupational, or other areas of functioning, and would normally have been evident for at least 12 months, end quote. WHO says that the decision was arrived at based on reviews of available evidence and reflected the consensus of experts operating in different regions and disciplines. However, the decision has been met with resistance from expected quarters, global video game trade bodies that say that more research is needed in the area. The pushback isn't surprising. The gaming industry is a moneymaker, and we aren't talking peanuts. In 2017, the gaming industry generated $116 billion. That figure went up to $135 billion in 2018. In fact, by 2021, revenues are expected to touch $180 billion. Although it's difficult to map how many gamers there are worldwide, the number is estimated at 2.5 billion. Asia Pacific is home to most of them. But even before the WHO's decision to categorize excessive gaming as a disorder, many countries have chosen to ban certain video games due to their impact on people playing them. Most recently, a number of Indian cities placed a ban on PlayerUnknown's Battleground, or PUBG as it's popularly known. It was dubbed extremely violent and capable of keeping players hooked for hours on end. India wasn't alone to come to that assessment. Nepal, China, and Iraq have all placed bans on PUBG. In fact, many countries have chosen to ban a variety of online or phone-based games for different reasons. For instance, Grand Theft Auto is banned in Brazil, China, Saudi Arabia. Meanwhile, Pokemon Go has bans in place in both India and Saudi Arabia. Wolfenstein is banned in Germany for its use of Nazi symbols, but the country has also banned Mad World. Meanwhile, Australia has banned multiple games, including Fallout 3 and Silent Hill: Homecoming. The reasons for these bans vary from country to country. However, what has become clear from the crackdown on online games and the WHO's alarming classification is that they do pose a danger to mental health. But regulating hours of use and the content of these games in the age of the internet is going to be a huge challenge. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.